We all knew that kid in grade school who the teacher said had so much potential. And what that meant is that they could be something great someday if they applied themselves, but at that point in time, they weren't necessarily acting that way. That's actually a lot like voltage. Stick around and find out why. Hi, I'm Daniel Bogdanoff. Welcome to the 2-Minute Guru. Today we're going to talk about voltage. And voltage is simply the difference in electrical potential energy between two points. A quick clarification, electric potential energy has to do with particles themselves, like electrons and ions. It's measured in joules, whereas electrical potential is measured in joules per coulomb, and it has to do with the electric field itself. The charge of the particles themselves is measured in coulombs. So if you take the electrical potential energy and divide it by the charge of the particle itself, all you're left with is that energy in space, the electrical potential. And volts are measured in joules per coulomb. So all this to say that all voltage measurements and values are simply a difference in electric potential between two points in space. So when I say that this is a 9-volt battery, what that means is that there's 9 volts of electric potential between the two terminals. The analogy I like to use for voltage is gravity, or more specifically, physical potential energy. Think back to physics 1. If I pick up this ball, it now has potential energy with respect to the ground, or whatever I choose to compare it to. Let's say I want to compare the potential energy between these two balls. I'll name this one positive, because I can, and this one ground. And I've given it a nifty little ground symbol here. Right now, there's no difference in potential energy, but as soon as I pick up one of these balls, there's now a difference in potential energy with respect to each other. When it comes to electricity, instead of height, we have electrical potential energy levels. Typically, we measure with respect to ground, which we consider to be 0 volts. Whether or not that's actually true is another discussion. Ground, or 0 volts, used to be, and sometimes still is, a metal rod hammered into the ground. But if you take a spaceship, for example, they still have a 0-volt ground reference, even though by definition, a spaceship cannot have a metal rod pounded into the ground. Also notice that unlike current, no movement is required for there to be a voltage. This ball could fall because there's a constant pull from gravity, but my hand is blocking the path. As soon as there's a path, the ball's gonna fall and there's current. Take this 9-volt battery, for example. Even though there's no current path flowing, I'm still measuring over 9 volts between the two terminals on the battery. And that's because I'm comparing the negative terminal to the positive terminal, and I expect that to be 9 volts since it's, well, a 9-volt battery. And that's all we have time for today. Thanks for watching. If this video is helpful, hit the share button, hit the thumbs up button. If there's any topics you want me to cover in the future, put them in the comments below. I'm Daniel Bogdanoff, and I'll see you in 2 weeks.